You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
All writers are prone to becoming so attached to our characters and stories that we struggle to see why a passage may not be working. It takes another set of eyes to help us nurture our writing to full maturity. At Black Wolf Editorial Services, we strive to enable writers to develop and grow, shaping stories into masterpieces that can stand the test of time. Editing services are provided for all genres and all age categories. Services range from critiques of the short story through to the line edits of the full-length novel and copy editing for those preparing for publication. We also offer assistance on generating a writer's bio for your website, as well as help with those book blurbs and promotional material. We won't abandon you to the masses. We want to celebrate with you and your successes. Black Wolf Editorial Services, nurturing your writing into maturity. For a full list of services and prices, visit us at blackwolfeditorial.com.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom?
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Hello, America. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. We're coming to you right now on crntalk.com. Also be having this episode air a little later on the home station, klrnradio.com. In case you're listening to us for the first time and you don't know who we are, feel free to check out our archives. They're available in multiple places. You can find us on Spreaker, Stitcher, SoundCloud, FM Player, iTunes, iHeartRadio, and so many more I can't think to mention all of them. We're also available on AMFM247.com Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays at 1 Eastern. We're also available on Red Nation Rising Radio every afternoon at 4 Eastern. And, of course, the home station Sunday through Thursday at 11 Eastern, 8 Pacific. I realize that for the last couple of weeks I've been doing this wrong because I keep telling you guys that we're on at 7 Pacific, 9 Eastern. It's actually 7 Pacific, 9 Central, which would make it 10 Eastern. Conversions are a little hard sometimes. All right, so anyway, we've got a really big show ahead for you. So we're going to kind of recap the week, start off on the new one, because this is, of course, the Sunday episode. So we're going to talk about this last week. We're going to talk about the upcoming week, what we think may happen, what we think what we're looking forward to, what we're afraid of, those type of things. So again, for those of you who may be listening for the first time, my name is Rick Robinson. I was staunchly in the Never Trump column all the way through the election. I kept trying to tell everybody I didn't think he was a good choice, didn't think he was the right choice for the country, but now I've gone from Never Trump to stuck with Trump. But we'll actually talk about that more starting right now on America Off the Rail.
It's time to hear the truth about America's biggest challenges. You're listening to America Off the Rails with your host, Rick Robinson.
Listen, folks, I'm here to tell you our political system is broken. The two-party system is dead. They have become one and the same.
Keep on doing what you do, Rick. You're my favorite host. Favorite host.
And in a surprising and disturbing move today, the Libertarian vice presidential candidate just agreed that rifles are weapons of mass destruction, and people on the terror watch list should not be allowed to purchase guns. So in other words, the party of freedom is liberty for me, but not for thee.
Compromise where you can. Where you can't, don't. Even if everyone is telling you that something wrong is something right, even if the whole world is telling you to move, it is your duty to plant yourself like a tree.
All right, folks, and again, this is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson, coming to you on crntalk.com and klrnradio.com. Now, as a reminder, we are on crntalk.com every Saturday and Sunday. We are coming to you at 7 p.m. Pacific, 9 Central, 10 Eastern. See, I did it right that time. And also, again, on old station, klrnradio.com. at 11 p.m. Eastern, and we're available there Sunday through Thursday, so make sure you check us out wherever you can find us. We do appreciate wherever you listen, however you listen, because without you, I don't have a show. And that may be something that you don't hear quite enough. Look, I understand how this works. If you guys don't listen, I don't get to keep my job. So I appreciate the fact that each of you tune in every single day. Our numbers have been continuing to climb, continuing to grow. So I just want to take a moment to say thank you to each and every one of you, no matter how you listen, whether it's live or Memorex, makes no difference to me. The simple fact of the matter is you are listening, and to me that is important. All right, so we're going to come, when we come back, it's already, believe it or not, time to take a break. When we come back, we're going to be discussing the continued meltdown on the left, the slight overreaction on the right, which lately I have to admit even I've been a part of, because because it's been kind of fun watching the left meltdown. I know that's a bad thing to say because, you know, I'm supposed to be the guy trying to call for unity and everybody calming down. But if I had known, honestly, if I had known the left was going to melt down quite this bad, I probably would have voted for Trump. That's right, folks. I didn't vote for him. I may have told you this last week if you tuned in, but I voted Libertarian in Oklahoma because I wanted to make sure Libertarian got to retain ballot access, which they did, by the way. So at least I felt like my vote counted for something. All right, folks, we are out. We've got to take a really quick break. We'll be right back here in just a couple.
Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson. Now, I said we were going to recap the weekend review first, so let's have a little fun at some liberal expense, shall we? I know. I'm supposed to be the bigger person here, but it's just been kind of fun watching the meltdown. And as I mentioned before we went to break, if I'd have known they were going to melt down this bad, I might have actually voted for Trump, just so I could say that I helped push him over the edge. But it was nice to give my state another alternative, and now we have a third party on our ballot, at least for the next 2 years, provided they can keep pulling in numbers. So at least maybe we are working towards some change. Now, without further ado, because as I mentioned, we have our own parody band, Third Rail Ramblers. They actually started with JD and Stacey, a show that was originally with me when I ran K98 Talk. They made the transition over with us to klrnradio.com, and then they have put their show on hiatus because JD got a really big promotion at the day job, and he's now out in California working his tail end off. So we have adopted said parody band, the Third Rail Ramblers. They now are primarily used as the station's parody band. And the funny thing is they haven't really had to even put out too much new work lately, because every time we turn around, something that they did that was good for about a year and a half ago is actually come full circle and is useful again. This one actually was originally written for Stacey, the co-host of the JD and Stacey show, but is so fitting today watching the liberal meltdown, especially the college kids that are thumbsucking under their desks and playing with Play-Doh and eating pizza. Without further ado, here is Buttercup from the Third Rail Ramblers.
Shut your mouth,
shut it up.
Buttercup, leave us alone. Your policies fail again like always, and then it's a waste. It's just the truth you've been.
Blah,
the policies
blah,
for the poor, they just create more, and somehow they'll vote for you again.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Maybe, baby, try not to cry.
Yeah, yeah.
Racial lines are trying to divide.
Yeah, yeah.
Every time we disagree, it's racist to you.
Ooh, 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 you're a two-hoo.
Why don't you scream and pout?
Scream and pout.
Buttercup, baby, when life lets you down.
Let you down.
A liberal clown, and then worst of all.
Worst of all.
You always call baby the state of birth.
Call the state.
Boy, you're feeling so hurt, and you do.
And you do.
So need the state, darling. Incessant in circles you drove. So shut your mouth,
shut it up.
Buttercup, leave us alone. A trophy for sure, participant you adore. Not results, not hard to wonder why.
But
you elected a fool just because he seemed cool one term without casting votes.
Hey, hey, hey.
let you down. Liberal clown, and then worst of all, you always call baby the state of birth. For you feel so hurt, and you do. So need the state, darling, incessant in circles you drone. So shut your mouth, buttercup, leave us alone. I heard you do. So need the state, darling, incessant in circles you drone. So shut it up, shut it up, buttercup, leave us alone.
All right, folks, so there you have it. Buttercup by the Third Rail Ramblers, our very own parody band right here on America Off the Rails, as well as the home station, KLRNradio.com. So we kind of take them with us everywhere we go, so they get played everywhere that I get played. And anybody else that wants to use them as part of the station is always welcome to do it. I actually know the masterminds behind that group personally through Twitter. We've gotten to know each other. You may want to follow along with them if you choose. They are at Two Cynic Al and also at O'Donovan. Actually, Beaker was a guest on Jen and Rick last Tuesday. This past Tuesday. So I do encourage you to go check that out as well. That episode's been a really big hit over there on our archives on Spreaker. It's making the rounds, and you'll find that, interestingly enough, that a guy that uses the Avi of Beaker actually does not talk like meep, 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 meep. He actually can put together sentences, and they're good sentences, too. But anyway, so I digress. So we have been kind of poking fun at the left now for, about 9 days? Because they're just completely in meltdown mode. I mean, look, the interesting thing is, if you look at the mainstream media, they are incessantly getting this point across that, as far as they're concerned, everyone that voted for Donald Trump is a racist. Now, I have something to say about that, because there is a segment of Donald Trump's voters that are racist. But what the Democratic Party, and especially the mainstream media, don't seem to want to address is there are still racists in the Democratic Party, too. So people in glass houses should not be throwing stones. Those of us in the conservative movement, and still at least tertiarily involved with the Republican Party, now that I can officially register as a libertarian and stay that way, I don't plan on changing my affiliation, at least not for right now. But I still am part of the conservative movement. And because of that, I do everything that I can to shout down and talk down the racist behavior that is currently coursing through the Republican Party and the conservative movement. But there is just as much of it on the other side. But they don't talk about that. They can't acknowledge that. That is one of the main differences between the Democratic Party and the Republican Party, and it's something that I hope never changes, because it's one of the only things that separates us at this point, because honestly, the lines are becoming so blurred, it's kind of hard to tell where one party stops and the other one starts. And unless it comes to this, we are really good at analyzing ourselves and realizing when we screw up, and we're really usually pretty good at holding our party leaders to a higher standard. Now, that doesn't always work. But with a Democrat, if they catch somebody doing something they're not supposed to, they sweep it under the rug, they try not to talk about it, they move on, they support them anyway. That was what a lot of the right was expecting us to do with Trump, even though there were lots of us that were watching some of the things that he was doing and saying, look, we really, really, really cannot support this. I don't care if you're okay with it, I'm kind of not. But again, like I said in the opening monologue, I am actually stuck in the stuck with Trump column now. And he has not even been sworn in yet, and it's already causing a meltdown all across the country. And that is the scariest thing of all. We have an entire segment of a population that has grown up in this participation trophy mentality that don't know how to deal with the fact that life is not fair. Look, kids, I'm going to tell you the same thing that I tell my kids every time they say this statement, because in Oklahoma, we have a state fair, and it comes every September. So every time I tell my kids something, or did when they were younger, most of my kids are adults now, every time they told me something that I told them something that they didn't want to hear, the first thing they started yelling was, but Dad, that's not fair. And I'm like, okay, you want fair? Good. Well, it's July, so you get to go in about September, because that's the only fair life's going to give you. And that's what these kids are still not coping with right now. Life is not fair. It's not easy. It's hard. And if you're going to continue to use the state to try to make your life easier, eventually you're going to wind up having to face and deal with those consequences. And that's what they're dealing with right now. They were expecting to get a continuation of the Obama gimme, 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 gimme policies, because Hillary Clinton was going to do much the same thing. I'm still not entirely certain what Trump is going to do, but I do hope he stops a lot of that. We'll actually talk about that more when we come back. Time for a break.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails. Now, you remember when I was talking about in the opening monologue that all Donald Trump voters were not racist, and no matter what the mainstream media tries to tell us, that much is true, that not all of Donald Trump voters were racist? He's getting some support in some really odd places. I have some audio from Michael Moore, of all places, telling us this election was not about race.
You have to accept that millions of people who voted for Barack Obama, some of them once, some of them twice, changed their minds this time.
Mm-hmm.
They're not racist. They twice voted for a man whose middle name is Hussein. That's the America you live in. That even though this country is only 12% black, the vast majority of this country, especially its young people, if you remember, it was really the only white demographic he won in 08, was 18 to 35 year olds. They poured out in record numbers. They made that happen. But if you put people through another 8 years where you haven't, there's no middle class jobs, they're struggling to get by, the basic things like you said, the price of a box of cereal doubles. These are the things that are important to people because they're trying to get by. And they're living from paycheck to paycheck.
This was a
All right, so there we have audio from Michael Moore, of all people, defending Trump voters and actually coming out rather harshly against President Barack Obama, who he once very staunchly supported, and actually I believe in his past has actually accused people that didn't vote for him of being racist the first time. Now, the interesting thing about that is that's not the only place that we're getting that type of language, and we actually have a clip we'll be playing later in the show, actually from somebody that shall remain nameless until I actually play the clip, because I think it'll be a really big surprise. But I want to talk about this for a second, because there's more than just this narrative going on throughout the media. You might have noticed that over the week, or what was it, Friday night, Mike Pence actually went to a play in a theater. Now, why a Republican vice president went to a theater? I'm sorry, really bad joke there. But the point here is, he was actually booed. Now, look, I understand that there is a good segment of the population that is not happy with the results of this election. And I don't think if Hillary Clinton would have won that things would have been much better. To be honest, I think there would have been another segment of the population that was just as unhappy. So I don't really see any way that we come back from this divide without actually finally starting to try to work together and remembering that we are all supposed to be Americans first. It's one of the things that I said the day after the election. First and foremost, we are all Americans. The fight should be over at this point, at least until we can figure out whether or not Donald Trump is going to be a good fit for the office. I don't know whether he will or he won't be. Some of his decisions still concern me, like not removing the made-up position that was bestowed upon Valerie Jarrett, because we used to make fun of Barack Obama when he started creating all these bizarre cabinet postings and filling them with crazy people like Jarrett, Van Jones, and a few others. We kept talking about how a conservative president would never do these things, how a Republican president wouldn't go through and invent postings just to put people that he favored in them to make his administration look better, because that's what leftists do. And yet, now we haven't dissolved that particular posting. We didn't do away with it. We've actually placed someone who is a rather polarizing figure to the left hand of Donald Trump. Now, a lot of the alt-right folks are pretty happy about Bannon's appointment, because they were rather upset that Reince Priebus looks like he is the shoe-in for the president's chief of staff. Now, there are a lot of folks that were really, really turned off by that, because they view Reince Priebus as part of the establishment. Now, don't forget, folks, for months I kept telling you Donald Trump was actually establishment. Nobody wanted to listen to me then, because he was too busy telling everybody that he wasn't. But it doesn't matter who was right or wrong at this point, and it doesn't really matter at this point how the next few years play out, because we're stuck with him. That's the point. It is time to come together. All of us on the right tried to come together behind Donald Trump, for the most part, except for the fringe movements in 2008. 2012, it was a little harder to do, because we'd already watched 4 years of the direction he was going, and a lot of us were fed up. That's why we couldn't understand why Romney couldn't beat him. Now, I still don't fully understand how it is that Trump managed to galvanize so many folks, or maybe it was just because so many that actually voted for Barack Obama in 2008 and 2012 actually stayed home in this election cycle and weren't willing to vote for Hillary. I have a sneaking suspicion it's actually a combination of the two. They were the two most unpopular candidates in American history for president, and that doesn't seem to be changing now that we are moving towards president-elect Donald Trump and actually starting to appoint some of his transition team. Now, even his transition team is starting to get a lot of headache and blowback. He's starting to get quite a headache from some of the people that he's appointing, and he's getting some blowback in the media and social media for some of those appointments. One of the biggest ones I think is delicious is the fact that they actually appointed someone who is termed a climate denier as the transition head of the EPA. Now, we'll actually talk about that a little bit more when we get back, as well as that audio that I promised of the mystery guest, not really guest, but someone who you might not have ever expected to utter the words that they're going to utter when we come back from this particular break. Now, again, this is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson, and again, I just want to take a moment to thank everybody who does tune in on a daily basis and remind you that we are fully aware here that you are the reason why we do what we do. And I just want to again thank you for taking the time to listen. We'll be right back.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
This is Slickery Trigger for Rebel Road Tactical. With proper care and feeding, your pistol will be ready when you need it, there to save your life. Shouldn't your gear be that good? Whether you need a holster for comfortable everyday carry or a tough-as-nails holster for your next training course, Rebel Road Tactical has what you need. Check us out on the web at rebelroadtactical.com.
Having a place to go after school will make you a better student. Having an outlet to express yourself will make you a better artist. Having something to do together will make you a better family. At The Y, we're helping build better friends, listeners, writers, swimmers, scientists, and musicians, one chance at a time. Give the gift of opportunity. Support The Y at ymca.net. The Y, for a better us.
All right, folks, and we're back again. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robbins. Now, as a reminder, America Off the Rails is a production of the Spark Radio Network. Sorry, I got to make sure we throw that in there for the music protection since we've been playing a little bit of music today. And now, as promised, we do have some audio from a very special guest. Well, not really a guest, but someone that you might not expect to be pro-Trump, because up until now, I really hasn't been. But it's kind of an eat-your-words kind of moment for this particular person, and you might recognize him from such special quotes as, "by a shotgun." That's right, Vice President Joe Biden had to come out and admit to a room full of folks that not all Donald Trump voters are racist, and here's why.
You lost because there's an awful lot of hard-working Americans who live in areas where they, in fact, will not pay much attention to them. They're not racist. Barack Obama warned these people. It's not like the races they voted for. But they didn't vote. This time, they're Democrat.
It's a powerful thing, Jamie, because they're...
All right, so there you have it. We have Vice President Joe Biden, who for a moment actually sounds cogent. I don't know. Maybe they fixed his meds finally. Freely admitting that the Democrats lost it this time because they lost a segment of the population that they have typically held on to. Now, this has been solidified for me by two separate statements. One from someone that I know who leans more right, another one from someone I know who leans more left. Bryce Robbins, who is a liberal, actually a liberal millennial, who does a show with me on Saturday mornings on KLRNradio.com called Finding Common Ground, actually on the episode we did yesterday, admitted that he knew probably about 7 days beforehand that most likely Donald Trump was going to win the presidency, and he knew based on a trip that he took to Delaware to a predominantly blue area that was covered with Donald Trump signs. Now, the interesting thing about that is around the same time he was coming to that realization, I have another friend, part of the Third Rail Ramblers, Mr. Beaker O'Donovan, that I mentioned was a guest earlier and really great guy, who actually made a trip home to where his family lives, which is in Pennsylvania. And he was in a predominantly, again, blue area. And he said, as far as the eye could see, there were Trump signs. And I don't mean little bitty stickers where you're like, you know, sticking it in your window and throwing something up behind it, hoping nobody notices, but you're still just trying to show your support for the person you believe in without somebody putting a rock through your window. We're talking like billboard-sized signs and big signs, Make America Great Again, Donald Trump, etc. And that was when those of us that were in a group that we use on Twitter to kind of help feed each other ideas, promote our work, etc., that's when we started coming to the realization that we might have actually missed something, and apparently we did, because without a doubt, the American people came out in, I mean, I guess you really can't call it a wave because the participation was kind of low this time, considering what they thought it was going to be. But it was still, if you look at the map, you know, the one thing that everybody that was a Trump supporter kept saying that a lot of us were laughing off was they kept saying how much it was going to be like Reagan on election night. And if you look at that map, it's really close. So for all of these people that are making noise about we need to do away with the Electoral College, and there's a really big movement right now trying, well, I say big movement, but there's a movement right now trying to get going that wants to actually do away with states in general and have everyone basically part of one big country, national ID, national registries, basically no more states' rights because states don't exist, no more Electoral College because states wouldn't exist, so it wouldn't be necessary. And that's a very scary concept to me. To be willing to throw out the baby with the bathwater just because you didn't like the results of an election, that to me is crazy. Look, folks, regardless, if he screws up, he's only got 4 years. Now, depending on how badly he screws up, you never know. He might manage to get impeached. And don't get me wrong, I'm not encouraging that at this point. Again, like I've been telling you guys all along, I was not a Donald Trump supporter, but I am now because he's going to be president. So at this point, rooting for him to fail would be as insane as getting aboard a plane and praying that the captain crashes. It doesn't make any sense to me because we're all on this ride together. Whether we succeed or fail now, all of us will be impacted. I really hope he finds a way to turn the economy around and get it roaring, because up until now, it's really not been doing much of anything. I really hope that some of these signals that we're seeing from places like Ford and all of this noise about Apple, maybe moving manufacturing back to America, as long as it doesn't negatively impact the pricing, I think it's a great thing. And honestly, I'll be honest, if I've got to pay a little bit more to buy an American product, I don't necessarily have a problem with that. I would rather buy American products. I really would. You know, that was Walmart's big selling point back in the 90s. When you'd walk into a Walmart, everywhere that you'd go, there would be signs that says all of our products are made in America. At some point, that changed. And that was one of the biggest reasons why, for the most part, I try not to shop at Walmart anymore if I can absolutely help it. Now, there are times when I have to go there, whether I want to or not, because now I live in small town USA and Walmart's kind of one of the only choices we have around, unless I want to drive into a bigger town that's about 15 miles away. But that was a decision that I made. The point of this is we have an entire group of people that, as it stands right now, are just ready to burn it all down because they don't like the results of the election. Now, I'm not saying that things would be any better if Hillary Clinton had won, because we had a vast segment on the right that were willing to do the same thing. But for all of the left to stand up when the right was clamoring that if we didn't get what we wanted, we were going to burn it down, and I say we because I am still a member of the right, even though I wasn't one of the ones screaming that, and now the left is doing the exact same thing, but media coverage says nothing about it, to me that is completely insane, because when those of us on the right were talking about how rigged the system is and how if things don't go the way we want, we'll know that something's broken and that we need to fix it. The problem with that is now that the shoe's on the other foot, it's protest. It's normal. It's American. We have the right to protest the president. But under Barack Obama, if you even spoke out against the president, you were racist. But now, if you're supporting the president, you must be a racist. Because let's face it, Donald Trump is a racist. That's the media spin. Look, I may not like Donald Trump. I may not like the bombastic way that he approaches things. But it worked. He is president-elect. I have to give him props. I didn't think he was going to be able to pull it off. I never in a million years thought that he was going to be able to beat the Clinton machine. And yet he managed to do just that. Not only did he beat the Clinton machine, he dismantled it. Hillary Clinton was so angry the night that she lost that she didn't even come out to support the people that had worked tirelessly for her for years to try to make sure that she got her moment in the sun as the first female president of the United States. Now, that's no big surprise to those of us that have been against Hillary for a long time because she's really good at leaving people hanging in the middle of the night. Benghazi, anyone? But at the same time, Donald Trump has made sure that there will not be another Clinton in the White House, at least for several years. They're already starting to groom Chelsea, so who knows? All right, folks, we're a little long. We have got to take a really quick break. When we come back, more on America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robbins.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.
Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675.
I've owned my company for 14 years now, and I can tell you that payroll is a four-letter word. I hate doing it. It eats up hours I don't have, and it costs me money I could be saving, but my accountant's too expensive, and I'm not sure who to call, but I know I need help.
We're Paychex, and we take all the hassles out of small business payroll. We save you time and money. It's easy. Call, fax, or give us your payroll information securely online, and we take care of the rest. We calculate the correct taxes, manage payments and direct deposits. We even send out your checks. Payroll doesn't need to be a four-letter word anymore. We're so sure that we can save you time and money that we'll give you a month's payroll free. Just for calling 877-757-2782. Get 1 month's payroll for free. Call Paychex right now. 877-757-2782. That's 877-757-2782.
And welcome back, folks. This is America Off the Rails. I'm your host, Rick Robinson, coming to you right now on crntalk.com as well as klrnradio.com. And again, available on amfm247.com, SHR Media, Red Nation Rising Radio, iHeart, Stitcher, iTunes, and multiple places all around the internet and terrestrial radio. Just want to thank everybody again for tuning in. Now, we are getting pretty long in the tooth for the show, so we're going to start winding things down. Got to have just a little bit more fun, though, at the liberal expense. We have another song put together by the Third Rail Ramblers that I actually forgot about. I actually put together a clip that I know you guys heard last Sunday with Crying by Roy Orbison in the background with a liberal mix of all the people that were freaking out. I had completely forgotten that the Third Rail Ramblers did this one. This was actually done right after the 2014 midterms, but it seems so appropriate now that we're going to go ahead and play it again. Like I said, with them lately, everything old is new again, and I know some of you have not heard it yet. So without further ado, this is the parody edition of Crying by the Third Rail Ramblers.
We were all right for a while. We held it. Left and right on fabled base, it failed to show. And though it hurt like hell, everyone could tell that we'd been crying. Tears of blue, crying. Tears of
again, folks, that was Crying, the parody edition by the Third Rail Ramblers. And actually, again, this that was actually done about a year ago, well, a little over a year ago at this point. It was actually in response to the 2014 midterm sweep, where we actually took maintained control of the House, actually took back control of the Senate. And it's when we were pretty sure that we were going to wind up with a Republican presidency. Against all odds, Donald Trump has managed to pull that off. I'm still not quite sure he should have been running as a Republican. I know some of you right now are still like, dang, Rick, just stop. I mean, look, I'm just being honest. I mean, this is what I do. I'm not gonna sugarcoat it. I'm not gonna tell you things you want to hear. If you want that, you can go listen to Hannity and some of the other ones that basically just do nothing but spout party rhetoric. I'm not that guy. Look, I'm gonna do everything I can to try to call this thing as close to the center as I can, because the simple fact of the matter is there's still issues on both sides, and we need to address those issues, not run from them. That's why I've been so angry about the right, or, well, actually the left, I'm sorry, and their total meltdown. That's why I was angry when the right was talking about much the same thing. I remember people on the right that were talking about if Donald Trump won the popular vote but lost the Electoral College, that they wanted to do away with the Electoral College. This is not an issue unique to one side or the other. This is an issue of, as long as my side wins, I'm good and I'm happy and we should keep things the way they are. But God forbid my side loses, because then we need to make some changes, because it's not fair that my side loses, because obviously I'm right. And that is what I heard over and over again from Bryce Robbins yesterday on Finding Common Ground, when I kept trying to point out that, you know, for the last 6 months, anytime we did a show together, every time I turned around, he was telling me that conservatism was a dying breed, we were going to be extinct, and I was basically a dinosaur. And he's still sticking to that, even though we have not only, again, despite all odds, maintained control in the House, we have kept the Senate majority, and we now have the presidency. He is still convinced that conservatism is a dying breed, because no one can admit the fact that just because someone else disagrees with your particular point of view doesn't necessarily mean that they're wrong. It also doesn't, unfortunately, mean that we're always right either. But the point is, folks, we have got to find a way to start coming back together, and we're not doing it. Now, I understand it's only been a couple of weeks, but I don't remember this, even with as much of the country that was upset over Barack Obama's election the first time and the second time, I don't remember this. I don't remember this complete and total shutdown. I don't remember people calling in sick because they couldn't cope with who was going to be the president. I don't remember college campuses grinding to a halt because they couldn't cope with who was going to be president. I don't remember high school students being allowed to walk out of class and protest because they couldn't deal with who was going to be president. This is the America that we currently live in. And this is a problem for every single one of us, whether anybody admits it or not. Now, at this point, we are coming to the end of the show. We're going to take another really quick break. When we come back, we'll wrap a few things up. This is America Off the Rails.
The following message contains a special offer for listeners of this station. Are you a man over 40? Are you constantly looking for the nearest bathroom? Do you wake up multiple times a night to use the bathroom? Right now, Perfect Prostate is sending out free bottles of their groundbreaking new formula to listeners of this station. Perfect Prostate formula was developed by medical doctor Mitchell Fleischer, and its ingredients have been clinically studied to reduce your frequent nighttime bathroom visits and promote healthy urine flow. Right now, preferred customers get their first bottle of Perfect Prostate absolutely free. There's nothing to lose. Perfect Prostate is guaranteed to reduce that constant urge to use the bathroom, especially at night, and promote healthy urine flow. Don't wait. Call now for your free bottle. Just pay shipping and processing. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251. Supplies are limited. One free bottle per household. Call now. Dial 1-800-675-0251. That's 1-800-675-0251.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 of pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Every day, the men and women of the United States Marine Corps stand ready to defend the American way of life. The few, the proud, the Marines.
Hey folks, I want to introduce you to a friend of mine, Dr. Richard Harden. We are on the same mission, which is waking up America. We just have different paths. So stay tuned for some information on how you can keep up with Richard and all his work.
Visit Richard's website at raharden.com. That's the World Wide Web at raharden.com. At his website, you can see a summary of the 6 books he has written, where purchases may be made. He also has a link to 18 videos on YouTube and several blogs about Christian beliefs. If you prefer, visit amazon.com/Kindle and type in Richard Harden to see and purchase his books.
All right, folks, welcome back. This is America Off the Rails, and we are just about out of time. So I want to kind of, I promise that not only were we going to have fun about the left's meltdown, we were going to talk about what to expect next. Now, Donald Trump is finally starting to make some of his positions a little less clear because he's backpedaling on a few things. but he's also working on his cabinet positions and other postings. So we're going to look to see what happens with some of those. Now, at this point, like I said, we have Bannon in the made-up position that Barack Obama created for Valerie Jarrett. Little disappointed that that position didn't go away. Little more disappointed that it was given to somebody as polarizing as Bannon. But it seems like to some, the main reason that position didn't go away was to try to help counterbalance the fact that Donald Trump seems to have given the chief of staff position to what a lot of folks are deeming as an establishment conservative. Now, it's interesting because it seems there are a lot of people that are really upset with a lot of his positions that were, are not positions, his cabinet postings, that were more of the alt-right persuasion, because at this point they're looking at it and they're like, oh, look, he's making a cabinet full of neocons. He's doing exactly what he told us he wasn't going to do. For a lot of folks, neocon is a bad word. I'm not sure I necessarily agree. A lot of folks that consider themselves neocons have done everything they can to try to do good work for the country. Happen to know one of them personally, Stephen Hamilton, the owner of a radio network that we actually worked together off and on with events. We actually went to CPAC together, AltCon Radio. Actually proudly considers himself a neocon. There are quite a few other people that do so as well. So I don't necessarily think that they are the devil that everyone paints them out to be. But then again, neither is Mike Pence. And like I said, another interesting thing that's going on right now is we have the left trying to paint him as a total devil because he actually tried to use government funding to help people that wanted to use the therapy to try to use gay conversion therapy. Now, if that was happening in my state, I would likely be speaking out against it. I don't think it's necessarily a good idea, but it's not my decision to make. I'm not the one that has to deal with homosexuality, and I'm not the one that has to deal with whether or not I'm comfortable being homosexual. Now, to say that the main reason everybody's not comfortable with being homosexual is because of the way society treats them, that's not necessarily, that's really not a true statement either. There are plenty of people that I know that are gay that weren't comfortable with it for a long time, and it really didn't have that much to do with society. It had to do with their own internal feelings about it, because they're like, you know, I when I was a kid, I always envisioned growing up having a family, and that's not really something that you could do for the longest time as a gay person. So that was the biggest thing that I wasn't comfortable about, was I couldn't have the white picket fence and everything as a gay person. Now that has changed. And for all of the leftists that are having a meltdown right now because they think that all of a sudden, with one fell swoop, Donald Trump is going to do away with gay marriage, and I know a lot of people on the right were hoping he might actually do that, I don't happen to be one of those people. Look, I have never hid my feelings about homosexuality. I don't have an issue with homosexuality personally because it doesn't affect me because I'm not gay. But I also don't want to hold everybody else to the same standard that I try to hold myself to, because they may not have the same religious convictions that I do. It's why I have always told people that for me the end all and be all has always been states' rights, because that's where problems actually get solved. Is if we turn things back over to the states and let them govern themselves, things can actually start getting fixed, because people that agree with the state's positions can either move there or other states can adopt them. And that was why my argument for gay marriage has always been states' rights. Now that's a moot point, because now it is the law of the land, and it really is just that simple. It plain and simply is the law of the land. And even Donald Trump in a 60 Minutes interview says he doesn't have an issue with that. Now, a lot of the left has been talking about how they do have an issue with the fact that he says that's decided, but Roe v. Wade isn't. Now, the issue with the left is a lot of folks think that once something is decided by the Supreme Court, that all of a sudden it becomes part of the Constitution. That is not necessarily true. And let's not forget that Roe v. Wade actually was pretty settled as long as it was sticking to the original language, and that is that abortion should be safe, legal, and rare. The problem is it's not rare. So I will be interested to see how the president deals with that particular aspect of it, since he did come out opposed to abortion in some respects. And also looking forward to seeing who he starts trying to float as a Supreme Court appointee. We are officially out of time. God bless. And happy Thanksgiving.
Screw you guys. I'm going home. Later.
Game over, man. It's game over.
Individuals and businesses with tax problems, listen carefully. Do you feel like you're losing control over your finances? If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, we can help you take back control. The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Take control of your tax problems now by calling the experts at Tax Mediation Services and take advantage of the Fresh Start program and new laws that may allow us to negotiate a settlement for the lowest amount possible. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected so you can take control of your financial future. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote.
Call Tax Mediation Services now at 800-610-9050. That's 800-610-9050. 800-610-9050.